Hey everyone, my name is Nate. Today we're playing part two, Kenya, Bridge of the Spirits. That got it right this time. What do you know? Well, this part two, I'm not going to be talking again. I'm just going to be talking here and at the end. Till then, you can just watch me play the game. So, let's get going.
Rusu's house is so far away.
You can see his lookout at the top of the cliffs.
Thank you. Right there. Right over there.
go.
One of Tara's memories. I should see where it leads me.
Thank you.
What's wrong with Rusu's house?
The trees look funny. Let's keep going.
There she is. The bridge is broken. Maybe the rock can help.
All right.
Woohoo!
I don't think they can hold it for long. I don't think they can hold it for long.
This pack is tiny. It looks like it could have belonged to one of the children. That corruption is powerful. There must be a relic nearby. I need to find another way around.
The forest has become too dangerous, Taro. The village is the safest place for you. If you hurry, you can make it back before sundown. I'll come for you when my work here is done.
Thank you.
then. I think we found Mr. Rusu. Come on, this way. She's here to help Taro.
The power of the mountain shrine is connected to everything in this forest. The trees here grew strong, drawing on its energy. And the land was once in perfect balance. But like all things, the mountain shrine follows a natural cycle. One that our village struggled to understand. As the shrine's power began to fade, a devastating famine struck our village. Taro lost his parents, and he was left to take care of Benny and Saya. I should have done more to help Taro. And now I can only watch as his spirit struggles.
We can still help Taro, Rusu. There's a relic covered by the corruption at your house. But I need a way to break through.
That weapon you carry, I sense it holds a deeper power.
The staff belonged to my father. It's been in our family for generations.
He must have been a great spirit guide. I may be powerless against the corruption, but I can teach you a new way to fight it back. To a trained archer, the bow is simply an extension of the body. A spirit guide staff is no different. Ground yourself. Feel the energy of the mountain. Draw on its power. Using your bow on these targets. When you are finished, feel free to practice at the other stations I've set up.
Woohoo!
Well, everyone, that's the end of this episode. My name is Danny. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, you know what to do. Until next time. Yeah. See you for part 3. See ya.